Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to do a bunch-less refillable cartridge out of those two cartridges we just refilled before.
Now, if you haven't checked our previous video, I suggest you to see the video. I'm going to put a link down below.
You might have a question, why do I want to do a sponge-less cartridge? I can just drill a hole and just refill it again and again, and it doesn't have any problems. There are a couple of advantages. The first one is you can clearly see how much ink in it. Rather than guessing how much in it, now you know. The second advantage is how much page you can print. Remember, in the last video, I'm going to show the link below. I told you how much ink is controlled by how much sponge in here. So even you have a big cartridge, you have a little sponge, you cannot add that much ink. And that pretty much limited how much ink you can put in and how many pages you can print. As you know, most of the time, the cartridge is damaged when you refill it. You refill it, then you have to prime it. And during that time, you introduce the risk of damaging it. If you can enlarge the volume, you can decrease your chance of damaged cartridge. I have an article, I'm also gonna put a link below. I show you how much ink was originally in there. So this is 260. And the original 260, we got about 8 mils, 7.5 mils.
So if we remove the sponge, the cartridge can hold 33 mils.
33 mil divided by 8. It's up to 4 times. Remember in the last video, I showed you each 8 mil of cartridge can print half ream of paper. So this is how much you can print before. Okay. If you just drill a hole and then refill it, you can print this much. Now if you convert it to sponge-less, you can print this much. Okay, for each refill. And for the color, each original Canon color cartridge can print this much paper. If you convert it to the sponge-less, you can print this much before you refill it. Okay, today's plan is to replace this cover with this cover. This cover has a refill hole. Okay, this is where we do refill. And this is air pressure regulator. On the top, there's a tiny air hole. So there are two things on this cover. I got a couple of customers for the black. They glue it backwards like this. So it's only possible for the black. So remember which one is the front, okay? Which one is the back. Okay, over go, you just cut this off, glue this on. Forgot to tell the tools that you need to prepare. We call it the GGSR. So you'll need a glue, gloves, sandpaper, and the rubber bands. We sell it really cheap at our website, but if you have them, you don't have to buy them. And the clear cover, I'm going to put it on the description. And you'll also need a utility knife. Another thing is you want some Dex tape, just regular tape, okay? So basically, you need a GGSR, utility knife, and some Dex tape. I cannot find my dispenser, so you'll need a tear of 3 pieces of tape. We want to get this, the print head protected. So instead of the sticky side down, that's going to glue it on the print head. You put the sticky side up towards me, towards the camera right now. So if I put it on it, this is the sticky side. Okay, the top is sticky side. You want to go over it, kind of put it underneath the chip. Now the second piece, you're going to go above this side of the tape, put a little bit more. Like this, and then make sure you use your finger, make sure it's sealed. What this one does is you're going to glue that cover, so there will be some glue coming down. You don't want the glue drop on the chip. And now the third piece, you just put it like this. So right now the sticky side towards sticky side, push it down. And now the printhead is protected. Okay, got one more to do. The second step is to cut the cover off. I usually do it on the edge of the table. You can see there's a seam right here. So I just use the knife, put it right on this seam. And I use this as a lever to go up and down. Okay, I'll do that. And then you're gonna hear a click, the knife goes into it. Then you just separate your hand like this. Okay. You can see how small the sponge is. Then you have all those things, just push the sponge down. Okay. Now the color one. Put on the seam. Go up and down, tear it off. Okay. So you're gonna fill all of them with ink. Before you take the sponge out, I do the sanding first, because there are gonna be some debris from sanding. So I don't want it to get contaminated. I don't want the printer get contaminated. So you can see there are grooves. Okay. Oh, by the way, the sandpaper is 150 grit. What you want is you want to sand until you cannot see the groove. You don't want to sand down too much. If you sand down too much, you're going to have a problem to put it in.
So also when you sand it, just turn it around a couple of times so you can sand it evenly.
So you can sand it evenly. So that look perfect. And after you're sanding it, use your knife. Just run it along the border. Make sure you pick up those little dirt. Okay, see this one? You want to pick it up with your knife. Okay. And now it's the color one. The same thing, we want to sand until we don't see that groove. So I still see it here. That'd be perfect. Now it's the cleaning time. Okay, now I take the sponge out. For the fresh cartridge, I usually do not do too much cleaning. I just rinse it out, make sure there's no dirt. Then you pat it dry with a paper towel. It's going to dry pretty soon, so give it like 10 minutes. So you don't want the whole cartridge get dried. So give it like 5-10 minutes, the top will be dry. And it will show you the color difference once it's dry. Okay, I'm going to do the color first. Before doing that, put a pen and pencil on the table and get your rubber bands ready and get your glue ready. And the color one is the hardest, so we're going to do it first. And take the little plugs off. And the first thing you want to do, you only got one try, okay, one time for the color. So the first time is try to fit it a few times. The way you fit it is go with the front first until you touch the end, and then press it down. Okay. The reason you want to try to fit it is you might still have some of leftovers from your sanding, so you make sure that gray can go in. Yeah, that look pretty tight. Good. Okay. And for the color, you have three chambers. And there are lots of people forgot to put a glue in the center, the center T. Okay. So let's do it first. Okay. First thing you do is put some excessive glue on the center T. The center T. And then now start put the glue in the center T. And now the edge. A liberal amount, so don't make it too thin. Okay, now we put the cover on. You only got one try, okay? Make sure you do some dry runs before you do this. And then press it down, now put the rubber bands on. Now rest it down, rest the shorter side on your pencil so it'll be flat. Now do the black. Remember what I said earlier. Make sure the narrow side is towards the front. Okay. Or back. Okay. Towards the electron ribbon. Okay. Don't glue it this way. Okay. Black is easy. You don't need a pre-glue. Just put it down here. Get lots of them. Press it down, okay. When you press it down, you're gonna see
and the glue foam fills in the gaps and the color becomes solid.
Now you can just leave it and based on your what kind of glue you use, I'll say that at least 5 hours to 10 hours before I add ink to it. Okay. Now actually I forgot about it, so it's one day already, so it's 24 hours, that'd be long. So next thing is take a look, see if there's any gaps, any air bubbles. It looked like I sealed really, really good. So if you see a really wide area, that's because you didn't have enough glue. Just dab, add another glue. The glue, for example, here is a little bit of white, you can see here. So you just drop a little bit of glue. And it's going to suck right in. It's going to suck the inside if it's not sealed. Just repeat what I said yesterday. If you forgot to glue the center T, you're pretty much done. There's no way you can glue the center T, but you can add drops all the way around it. Because you've sanded this down, so it's tiny little bit shorter than the original cartridge. If you put a lot of glue under here, that make it even shorter. So if you have problem to fit it in your printer, you want to file down this cover a little bit. So make sure you file down all the glues here if you cannot fit it in. Okay, next thing I'm going to double check if it's sealed airtight. I normally don't do that after I examine it, so I'm pretty sure I'm sealed airtight, but just to show you how to test it. And this syringe is included in your kit, and it has a flat top. This is used to blow air into the air hole. So if I close this, and if I blow a little bit of air into the air hole, it's going to increase the pressure inside the cartridge. If there are any leaks around the corner, I'm going to see it. Otherwise, the air is going to come in from the bottom. I just blow a little bit, tiny bit of air. Sometimes I blow under the water. You can see only the ink coming from the bottom. There's no air around the cover. Now I release the air pressure. Now I'm doing for each of the three colors.
Now I can add the ink. Add as much as you want, add all the way to the top.
So now with the knife, I can remove the protective tape.
Some people are against using the paper towel to wipe the nozzles, which is the bottom of the printhead. I'm a wiper. I haven't found it damaging any printhead after I did a couple hundreds, maybe not a thousand.
Okay, after you've done it, remember, if you see my last video, if this is the cartridge, and you get a filter here, the filter funnel. Okay, although you added the ink in here, the funnel itself is still empty, so you need to get this funnel full of ink before it can work. And there are two ways. One way is using the syringe here. Just like what we did before, we pump a little tiny bit of air, okay, not too much. Okay, I'm gonna pump maybe just like this much, okay. And you can see the red is flowing out, okay. And after you pump it, open this up, release the pressure, and put it back. Okay, I'm going to pump the blue. Okay, make sure that the blue color coming out. Then release it. You can see the air bubbles. If you do not release the pressure, it's going to flow out all the time. So after you after done it right, release the pressure, you can see there's no ink coming out. Even you see here, there's no ink coming out. Okay. And the second way is, of course, using our old priming clip. This is not including in your kit, but if you want to use it, I also I recommend maybe using the priming clip if you worry about damaging the printhead. Do not put too much air into this. If you do like a half of a syringe, it's going to damage it. I think the safest, the maximum, maybe 2 mL. That's the maximum it can take. Because if you have too much pressure, it's going to damage the delicate nozzle underneath. Okay. So one thing is that because this is a little bit shorter, and when you put a priming clip, okay, you'll find it pretty easy to put it on. So now you have to use your finger, so like a lever, when you draw the ink, okay. If you use a syringe to draw the ink, you have to use your finger, hold on this and press it down, okay, then you can draw it, so you can seal it, seal it tight. Okay, now it's ready. For the color one, if you see this one stops you from going in, because this thing in the middle, you bend it back a little bit and press it in. Okay, it's looking pretty good except the cyan. We're just going to do one more cleaning using the printer's building routine. So we're going to take the cyan, we're going to put maybe 2 mL of air.
Oh, I can also use the priming clip.
So remember, I use my hand to squeeze it in. Because the priming clip draw the ink from all three colors, you should see this color be black. What I like about the priming clip is it draw ink from all three chambers, so you always get a balanced. All three chambers get a balanced pressure across all three after you do it. And one thing I like about the syringe, priming syringe, is you can individually unclog individual color. Ooh, it's even worse. Let me use the printer's building function.
And clean it.
I also use a deep clean. I found that the Canon's regular clean doesn't do anything.
Much better.
So I'm going to use the building function and do one more clean. Much better. And so this is second deep cleaning, and I only got a little bit of strap here. So what I'm going to do is I'm using the most effective tool, which is time. I'm gonna set this in the printer for 2 hours. Then I come back and check on it. Okay, after 2 hours, we do more cleaning. Just do another check. See, time is your best friend. So, I. Normally, those are caused by microscopic air bubbles. So, if we take it out and do a cleaning and do the priming, it's like using a cannon to kill a mosquito. So the time will solve it. And there are lots of people, they just bring all the tools and try to fix it right away. And they make things worse. So all we did is just leave them for like 2 hours. So this is our first one after we modified. And then we did a prime. And in the priming, you can see the color is kind of red color, kind of bleeding the yellow color. And this normally is the pressure is not balanced. So the balloon has lots of pressure, have nowhere to go. It's squeezing the magenta, and the magenta squeezing the yellow. Okay. So after prime, we probably prime too hard. We put too much pressure on the blue. So on the, I should call it cyan. On the cyan, so cyan pressed the two other colors. And then we use the printer's building function to do a clean. And immediately it cleaned out the pressure problem, but it still left some microscopic bubbles, and which we did a second deep clean right away, and I cleaned out those bubbles. But then there's a big one here, which we just sit in the printer for 2 hours, and now it's perfect.
If I still cannot solve it, I'll just repeat it and do the same thing again and again until it's ready. I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnologies.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Thank you. Cheers.